teenagers, they're hideous creatures. We're all cringe at one point in our life. And there's a Reddit where you can show off how much of a dork you were. I'm talking about blunderyears. Let's look at these clowns. I was one of those who used to wear a beanie in the middle of the summer. You know, I tried that once because I was in my skater bro phase. I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed of that one day of my life. The only thing about this picture I regret is that a collection of Beanie Babies was not larger. Why do you have the thing that pricks Cinderella's finger? What the fuck is that thing called? Okay, it wasn't Cinderella, it was Snow White, but same thing. Why do you have a spinning wheel from the ancient times in your house? It's an interesting photo, nonetheless. Okay, these two are cool as fuck. The guy in black is kind of hot, not gonna lie. I'm the one in the white tux and the plastic gas station sunglasses before prom in 2002. Nah, but your friend is way hotter than you. I'm sorry. You look like a dunce next to him. Get a new friend who doesn't look that. Dude, look at him. Look at him. Damn, I've got a man crush. The early 90s were not kind to my family. Jesus Christ. I think your family was out of style for the 90s, to be honest. This looks like a 70s family. Honestly, I can respect it. It's colorful, it's bright, it's vibrant. You never know, one day some fucking future society will have colorful outfits like this, look back on us and be like, they were so bland. This is by far the worst photo of me in existence. Back when you had to put on a fucking Iron Man costume to get your fucking teeth straight. Goddamn. Oh my god, this is so cute. One of my best friends and I in early 2012. Oh my god. I think I was this age in 2012 also. We were 8 and we had our own band. No, I think I was 10, 11. The face is funny, but the bowl cut is no joke. He looks like a sitcom character or something. I don't know, he just looks like... ugh. That's a desk we've all had. For some reason, it feels so early 2000s. Love it. You can tell what celebrity's popular by just looking at a yearbook from a school in any given year. 2000 to 2005, all the white kids were being Eminem. Just a couple of badasses circa 19. Oh, that's so cute. It is really colorful. I think we need to get these fucking colors back. If I have a fucking kid, I'm making him look like a complete, like a fucking candy cane. I didn't realize I was pretty gay at 15. I like your style. Again, you can tell what celebrity's popular. 2003, when I was pretty pissed at Avril Lavigne for ripping off my totally unique style. Oh my god. You know, all the Avril Lavigne fans were the rebels back then. Because, you know, Britney and Christina were the popular ones with the fucking low-cut jeans and the crop tops with, you know, their midriff showing. If you dressed like this, you were a rebel. Britney's cooler. This kid's throwing up gang signs in the whitest photo I've ever seen. Never passed up a chance to throw up West Side, even in school. 1999, I thought I was so cool when I figured out how to make the peace sign. I'm not gonna lie, kid, you're fucking, he's not a kid anymore, but you are cool as fuck. And your room is insane. Look at the shit, he's got fucking Arthur, Mickey Mouse, fucking Simpsons, Rugrats, that shit's, none of it's popular anymore. None of it. You're a geezer now, which is sad, but you know, you were cool like this at one point. 15 or 50. If you just look above your eyebrows, just your forehead and up, you look 50. Underneath that, you're 15. I cannot believe you're 15 here, though. That is a very old 15. 2010, it was my first Lollapalooza, and I thought this outfit was everything. I remember people used to dress like this, and they thought they looked so cool. You know, to be fair, they probably did. Again, I'm looking at it from my toned-down 2002 eyes. Matrix-inspired outfit I wore to school in 2008. The way you said this, it seems like you just wore it cuz. It's not like it was Halloween. You were just like, ah, I like this guy. I'm going to be him for now. You literally saw someone in a movie and you're like, that's me now. That's kind of cool. Not going to lie. I wish we all had the cojones that you do. I don't even celebrate Christmas and I have creepy photos with Santa. That's just an American tradition. Come on. Christmas morning 50 years ago. Damn, you gotta feel bad for kids from 50 years ago. When your Christmas gift is an encyclopedia on tropical fish? Imagine asking your mom for whatever kids ask for, PlayStation 5, and getting a fucking encyclopedia. Freshman year, I referred to every woman I met as ma'am, regardless of age, and affected a southern accent in San Francisco. Why the fuck would you do that? I don't know. That's weird, bro. But you look cool. You look cool. You definitely look like a southern dude. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because, you know, the stereotypes, you know, doing it with sisters and all that stuff. But, you know, what the fuck? How my mother decorated my baptism party when I was 15. What happened to Nicolas Cage memes? Weren't they popular at one point? Oh my god, this is fucking cool. This is cool. This kid looks cool, first of all. And that background is sick. They need to make these things come back. I know this says 94, but this is definitely like a layover from the 80s, early 80s. The fucking photo company that does your school was just like, ah, we'll keep it. We're not going to buy new ones because that is an 80s look. I love that. That is so cool. 94, you couldn't convince me that my extra large polo wasn't peak style at age 11. 1994. I kind of like this. I think it looks cool. It's unique. I feel like now the look everyone goes for is the yacht party attendant. You know, like you've got invited to a yacht party, put on your boat shoes, really short khaki shorts, you know, fucking vineyard vine shirt or some shit. You know the whole look. The fuckboy look. Pirates of the Caribbean was why I had dreads. Yeah, you can't have dreads now. You'd fucking get ripped for having cultural appropriation. You would get torn to shreds on Twitter. Me at 11 making a Facebook profile pic. You know, this was probably like 10 years ago, because I feel like I'm the same age as him. It was more than 10 years ago. And the fact that you had the wherewithal to Photoshop yourself this well that long ago, you're probably a graphic designer who's making bank right now somewhere. It's kind of weird. You're looking at me flirtatiously, and you're looking over your shoulder flirtatiously. You look kind of like Justin Bieber, too. In high school 2006, yes, I thought a Batman belt buckle and a sideways red robotic hat was cool. You're cool. Those were your glory years. I know you're a fucking old man now, so, you know, you act like you don't like it, but you wish you were that guy again. You wish. Your bones hurt now. You can't get up and sit up without back pains now because you're old, buddy. You're old. It's not 2006 anymore. It's been 18 years since then. I did the exact same pose in every single picture from 9 to 13. It did not suit. Are you kidding? Are you kidding? You look amazing. Crisscross gonna make me jump on my bed. Wow. I thought Crisscross only had like 3-4 songs that were popular, and people had posters of them. Crisscross were cool as fuck. Isn't one of them dead now? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make it dark, but you know, one of them's gone. It's only Chris now, or Cross. I don't know. Easily the best day of my life, Christmas 1997. I still remember getting a PlayStation 2. You know, the ones that I remember. Well, the PlayStation 3 is the console I had the most fun on. But literally, some dude went to my dad's office and was like, you want a PlayStation? I'll sell it to you for $10. I don't know if there was cocaine in it or something, but my dad bought it, and I used that for years, and I traded that in for a slim PS3. Should have opened it up, the old one, to check for cocaine. But, you know, that wasn't as special as the PS2. Getting the PS2 and the Wii for me was, yeah, PlayStation 4, when you pay for it yourself, it's just like, ugh, why am I doing this? This costs too much. $400 fucking dollars. Oh my god, that is the cutest photo I've ever seen. Been a weirdo forever, 1996. Oddly enough, it looks like some sort of like fucking Star Wars futuristic outfit when I first saw it. That is cool. I'm surprised this never caught on, to be honest. In the winter, you don't really use your arms, and it would get all these stupid kids off their fucking phones. It's basically a straitjacket, but it's fashionable. 2010, when being quirky and random was all the rage. Yeah, I guess having a cone on your head is quirky. It should still be the rage, because what's the point of being serious? Huh? New bike, Nana shades, and pink tassels. Early 90s were a weird time. I'm gonna say one thing. you call this weird again. Yo, the car in the back? That is a fucking caddy. Damn. But you call that weird. I think it's kind of cool. People are fucking too serious now. Oh, I gotta look this way, that way. Can't have any embarrassing moment because it'll be on social media. Look. Back then, you didn't know what was cool, what was fashionable. You just did what either your fucking parents gave you or what you liked from your purest intentions, I think. You thought the fucking bike with pink tassels and wearing your those shades was a good idea because that's what you wanted, not because you were influenced by something else. There were no influencers. It was just you. Just you, man. Just you. Ugh. One more. Hey, ladies. I want him to recreate it at whatever age he's at now, because clearly this is, again, probably 20 years ago. I want him with his... I want him to redo this and just show it to his family, because he probably has one by now. This is probably 20 years old, because time flies, huh? Time just goes away. It's 2022 already. Already. If you enjoyed, give the video a like. Subscribe. Do it, pussy. Do it. Do it, pussy. You won't.